Wasabi. In today's video, I will be sharing with you how I did this though. This is also called as the Japanese Igari makeup or the hangover makeup, or this is normally known to us as the drunk blush makeup. So this is how it looks like. If you're new here, don't forget to hit subscribe. So if this is something that you want to learn about, please keep watching. Okay, so starting with my freshly washed face, I've got nothing on my skin right now except some treatment serum down here because I'm currently having some skin issues. Akin sobrang lalanya, but I will tackle that in another video. So before I put anything on my face, I would like to start with this Monistat anti-shaving cream. I've been using this as my primer. If I want to protect my skin from makeup or certain elements, I normally use this, just a little tiny bit of product, and then just smooth it over my skin. So in this case, I want to protect my cheeks. It's basically dimethicone, so it sort of acts as a shield to your skin from any product. Keep in mind that this product, dimethicone, works similarly with your Smashbox primer, but for a lot cheaper price. This is only $68. Mura lang siya compared to Smashbox. And you need a very small amount kasi pag marami, if you put too much, the product's gonna roll down your face. Magkaka-bead siya parang nipag-nipag. So you don't really want that. You just need a little pea-sized amount and then smooth it over. So you can see kanina glossy siya, ngayon naging matte na. This is actually a mattifying primer. So it's skin protectant. You can use it as a primer. Okay, so once that is set, I normally apply my favorite sunscreen. Shake it well. And apply it all over. Then put the rest down your neck. So let's get on with my foundation. Today I will be using the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. I'm just gonna apply a little bit of this. I'm using shade 125 or nude beige. And put a little on my brush. Yeah. Very small amount. I'm not really into full coverage foundation. I like everything lightweight. And I realized na dahil hindi ako sanay mag-heavy or full coverage foundation, I had a hard time going out and, you know, trying to conceal my skin issue here at the height of this issue. Ngayon, I'm just healing everything, so medyo smooth na ulit yung skin ko. But I will reveal to you what happened in another video. I'm just waiting for everything to fully heal para end-to-end yung video. So just buff it in and don't forget to put the remaining down your neck, always in upward motion. Para mag-blend sila seamlessly. Pet peeve ko yung iba yung mukha sa leeg. So just to make everything look put together and your body in one piece, just make sure to put the remaining product on your brush, sa neck. Let's go in with the concealer. For today, I'll be using this CoverGirl Olay I Rehab. Hindi pa siya upos. After this, I wanted to try a Libre concealer because I heard that's good. I put the rest sa taas ng lid ko para brighten din yung eyelid ko. Also, it acts as a good base for your makeup. And then, I set my concealer with my L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Powder Foundation. And this one is in 160 Sand Beige. Okay. After I do my concealer, I normally go in with my highlight. For today, I'll be using the BLK Cosmetics Contour Palette in Sunkissed. And I get this fluffy eye brush. Highlight here sa brow bone. Normally, after concealing, I do my brows, but since my brows are microbladed, I skip that part. Yeah. And then, I will be using this ColourPop Cheek Palette. I forgot kung ano ito, but I'll list it down below, and I'll use this for my cheeks, because this is more pink toned. Yeah. Since we're doing the Drunk Blush makeup style, medyo pinky siya, I want the pinky tone on my cheeks. So, getting this fluffy brush, I'm just applying tops of my cheek. You can see the difference. See, mas golden tone yung sa eyes, mas puti yung nasa cheeks. Also down my nose bridge. And I'm gonna put a little bit sa lips. For today's blush, since we're going for a very natural looking, it's actually called the Japanese Igari makeup or hangover makeup, or it's commonly known to us as drunk blush makeup. And since we're going for the natural Japanese styled look, I'm going in with this Gorgeous Cosmetics cream blush in Peaches and Cream. Because I feel that mas natural siya if you use a cream or a lip tint than using a powder blush. But you can always top it off later with powder blush, which we will be doing mamaya. Also, since meron kong konting texture dito sa cheeks, hindi maganda pag pinowder mo agad kasi it will layer and cake up. No matter what powder that is, it will do that. So let's go with the cream blush first. Okay, so let's start here. Put a little on your nose. And swipe it across. Okay, the Japanese style makeup is parang the entire thing here is red or blushed or flushed. It's the same look you'll get from the sunburn at the beach. I would assume it's the same look you'll get kapag maybe you burn ka during winter. So basically the style is get your cream blush and then just put a line across your cheeks hanggang dito sa dulo and then blend it down. That's the easiest you'll do to achieve this look. You concentrate from here downwards. Unlike your regular blushes, you just put here up above. No. With this Japanese style makeup, you just swipe it across. Kailangan horizontal siya. Across your nose. And then just blend it downwards. I have a little texture here, so I just put the colors very spiny kasi ayoko siyang mag-layer masyado. Ayoko siyang mag-cake. Yan, ito medyo pronounced na. Being very careful in this area. Can add a little more. It's best to use your fingers with this. Because you're using a cream brush. Okay. To intensify the color, you can also add your powder blush on top of the cream blush. So, banda dito lang siya. And then just spread it. don't forget to put some on your nose. If feeling mo sobrang dami yung red, you can go in with your powder and just clean up the mucus medyo baba. It's not supposed to go way, way down. So you can clean up dito sa may lower cheek. Also to give a stark contrast from the red to the white. Ayan. So dito yung red, and yung blush, and then yung white. Okay. Some videos I've seen they add faux freckles, but I'm not really into freckles. I just like the natural flushed look. Okay. I'm sure you can't see it that much, but my texture is right here. So na-cover na siya ng blush. I'm just adding a little powder to add contrast. For my eye makeup, we have to go really light and natural on this, because that's how the Japanese gari makeup should look like. So parang dapat fresh lang itsura, lightly flushed and fresh. So we're going in with this ColourPop Super Shock in Wattles. This is a matte brown shade that will be applied here towards the outer corner papasok. It will give your eyes a natural, subtle brown shade. Light lang. From out to in. Okay. And then, we're going in with this J-Cat Eyeshadow Trio. This is in Dulce de Leche. We're going in with the lightest shade into the inner corner to draw light, and then the middle shade sa gitna so that the light hits the middle part of your eye. Just blend them together. And then the darker shade sa dulo. You can build this up and diffuse it towards your brow bone. You don't have to go too crazy about it. Kailangan light lang yung hand. And just bring it up a little. Para naka-blend siya dun sa highlight mo. Just blend everything together. Okay, so for today's eyeliner, I will be going in with this K Palette Real Lasting 24-Hour Eyeliner in brown. Also, do not do a cat's eye with this style of makeup, because the Japanese style will always use the dog eye style na pababa siya, or it just follows the natural curvature of your eyelid. Yung cat's eye kasi pataas, right? So this one, we will do the puppy eye. Follow mo lang natural downward slant ng eyes mo. So it's very thinly defined. I don't go all in sa loob ng inner corner. Just here. Yan. Kung saan nag-i-end yung iris mo. Dyan lang. And then dito. Very thin line will do. Okay, so now that is done, pababa lang siya. You can extend it a little longer para lang mas define siya. Okay, so now on with the lips. For today, since natural look lang siya, let's go in with this Lancome Juicy Shaker in Mangoes. This is one of my favorite juicy shakers. You just have to shake it really well so the oil and the pigment mixes together. And then let's go ahead and apply it. Oh, before anything else, don't forget to prime your lips with a lip balm. Today, I will be using my NYX Lip Moisturizing Stick. I really love this. Para soft and creamy yung lips mo. And then, let's go ahead and use this Juicy Shaker. Well, apply it in the middle of your lips. And there you go. So this is the finished look. It's very simple. It's very easy to do. Para lang siya na sunburn. Very light, very natural. You skip the contour because normally the Japanese don't really contour their faces because they go for the youthful, young-looking makeup. So more on the highlight, making your skin glow, making your skin smooth. Parang you diffuse the texture with the primer, with a good primer, and then you have your lightweight makeup, BB cream if possible. Yan siya. Don't forget to hit thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more makeup videos. And I'll see you in my next review. Bye!
So let's get on with my foundation. Today I will be using...